The Cowboys have named an extended squad to face the Eels this weekend as players continue to grieve over the death of young teammate Alex Elisala. The club says they're both shocked and devastated by yesterday's tragic news.
There's no question this was one of the toughest press conferences Peter Parr and Neil Henry have had to do.
We're obviously devastated, shocked, and supportive.
The football's taken a back seat. We've got a few days to prepare for that trip down south, so we're just making sure that everyone's okay.
Yesterday's tragic death of Alex Elisala has rocked the club. A young man with a bright rugby league future, he played Queensland under-20s last year and came off the bench for Samoa just a fortnight ago.
He's a good young man. That's the first thing that I'll always remember, that he was always good, always respectful.
Good friend James Seguiaro paid tribute in his own way last night. The former Cowboy starred in the Panthers' demolition of the Eels.
Seguiaro grabs a second. He points to the sky.
At Red Hill, the Broncos are bracing themselves for the Bunnies' big boys on Friday night, but there'll be no fancy stuff.
I can bring out a chip and chase this week if you want, whatever, but no, we've got razzle-dazzle football players in our team, but the way the competition is at the moment, you have to play some tough grinding footy to actually win games.
Manly did its best to rattle Souths last week and today paid the price. Steve Mattai will miss a week after his hit on George Burgess went wrong.
Hey, let us swear. That was f***ing awesome, man. Oh, I love playing outside that guy. Just when he pulls it off, I just lose it.
While Richie Faoso's out for 8 weeks, taking the early guilty plea for his 2 spear tackles on Greg Inglis.